Hi everyone, thanks for joining for our next video as we're talking through how to adjust strategies for self-care regarding nutrition. As I mentioned in my last video, I am a registered dietitian by trade and have been practicing for almost 15 years, but I'm also a mom of two young boys with very specific preferences. I'm currently working from home with my husband and kids and dog and know how difficult it is to balance. So when we're talking through adjusting strategies, many of the strategies we're going to talk through are ones that I personally needed to use to try to have some semblance of that picture of nutrition and wellness in my life. I want to reiterate that this is not about meeting an ideal, but it's understanding what that could look like and thinking through if there are opportunities to get a step closer to that. We want to be really realistic here that healthy eating in general is an effort, and the current climate does not make that any easier. You know, be kind to yourself. And as we continue to talk through these strategies, think about what is really going to work and what are areas that really are not going to be feasible for you right now. Again, my name is Margaret Ostrander. I am a quality assurance manager within Cohen Veterans Network Central Office. And let's jump into some of these different strategies that you might need to adjust right now regarding nutrition. First, thinking about areas where you can add instead of subtract. It can be really overwhelming to think about cutting back on some of your favorite foods, but instead thinking about areas where you can add. So can you add an additional snack of having a fruit? Can you increase your portion size of vegetables at a meal? This next piece is also helpful for being budget conscious as well as health conscious and trying to substitute nuts, nut butters, beans, and eggs for meat. So meat tends to be the most expensive part of that meal, and there's a lot of wonderful healthy options which also provide protein, like beans, like nuts, like eggs, which might be great alternatives to try at this point in time. Choosing whole grains on a budget. There are some really great grains out there that are somewhat cost prohibitive. So things like quinoa, farro, freesia, those might be too expensive for you right now. But thinking through what would be more reasonable. So brown rice, old-fashioned oats, barley. These are things which are whole grains and also are much more affordable than what I call like the glamour grains. Include a variety of colors of fruits and vegetables. You know, I want to caution you about products that are talking about boosting immunity or juices that are going to provide you with some super extra benefit. Really, all of the nutrition research is focused on eating those, you know, whole foods. So what does it look like from having the flesh of the fruit, the juice that's inside of it, and all of those different components really being of the biggest benefit. I would suggest trying fresh or flash frozen if you have those things available. What flash frozen means is if you go to the grocery store and you look at the bag of, let's say, broccoli, the only ingredient listed will be broccoli. If it has an added cheese sauce or cream sauce, those tend to have a ton of extra salt, so would not be, you know, the most recommended option. Before you go grocery shopping, create a list with potential substitutions, understanding that availability might be limited, and because the grocery experience may be a bit more overwhelming than it previously was, thinking through, you know, if they don't have this vegetable, what's something that I can sub out instead for this recipe that I'm thinking of trying? You might also want to try different food attainment methods. So if you've been having a hard time with grocery delivery, then maybe trying to go to the store and vice versa. You know, you might be able to find some type of meal plan like the HelloFresh, where you're able to try something different and have a different food attainment method that gives you some different flavors than you're used to cooking with and provides a different level of something to look forward to when it comes to food. Farmers markets, because there are less steps from the farm to a farmer's market than getting those products to a grocery store, you might have an opportunity to have a bit more variety in what products that you're able to obtain. Some farms are even doing some direct-to-consumer work, so you might be able to see, depending on your area, if that's something that's available for you. thinking about pre-planning meals and meal times whenever possible. If you look and your schedule is, back-to-back from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m., you know, that's not going to be the day where you're able to be thoughtful about creating a three-course meal with full of roasted vegetables and brown rice. Maybe that's a time where you have a peanut butter sandwich on whole wheat bread and a handful of baby carrots, which takes almost no prep. You can consider using an app like Supercook, which finds recipes based on the ingredients that you have within your home. I try to make as much as you can a conscious effort to sit for meals away from stressful distractions. So if you kind of have the TV on as a background noise and you find that that's really detracting from your enjoyment of a meal, really trying to have that quiet space, playing music, lighting a candle, whatever you can do to try to make that an even more pleasant experience. You might want to consider like a special event. If you asked me how many times that I've made turkey meatloaf, it would be hard to place when that happened, how that happened. But thinking through, maybe you could do something like a picnic. And if you don't have the opportunity to go outside, is there something you can do in your living room? Having a chopped competition. So finding what are three random things that you have in your fridge, call a friend, see if they have those same random three things, and can come up with some type of wonderful meal from there and kind of have a picture competition. Maybe a role swap if you are living with a friend or a roommate and one of you tends to do most of the cleaning and one the cooking, switch and see how that feels. Also a date night, thinking about how you can recreate all of those special moments and memories, even when you are kind of limited in your ability to go out. So thank you so much for joining us today. I hope that you found those tips helpful. And again, we're so happy that you are taking this time to devote to your self-care. Thank you so much.